Just tied this little fly out of this material over here. Took this rope and I got a piece of that because I know they like white. This is the lure I use here, because if you case you've never seen the show before, this is my favorite snake lure. So I'm gonna try to imitate the snake lure here. In case you didn't see that last one. See that got a little yellow in there from a if you keep a little, take it your bag and put a marker in there, a highlight marker, pink or yellow, you're gonna get UV reflectant material on there that will attract the fish more than normal bait will, because fish key on UV light as well. And they can see like a rave that glows for them in the sunlight. Now, I was gonna show you. I just used a little bit of the rope material and I tied it with a couple half hitches. Now let's see if we can't catch a fish on this ridiculous thing I just tied, okay? And I don't think I'm not gonna go and mess around with this because I don't have many, I don't think I have many casts in it because I don't have any glue. I just half hitched some monofilament, which is not the best thing because it doesn't hold its knots very well. On a fly, you're supposed to use thread, you know, thread's really good. Or, you know, what you can use is something they use in London, or UK, I mean, they use in London, in the tower they use this. When they go fishing, they use, stretchy material around the bait. They tie the bait to the hook kind of thing when they do beach fishing. So it's a material, look, there's only half a rod here. It's a material called something stretchy. No, it's not called something stretchy. It's called something, but it's elastic. Bait elastic it's called. My apologies for being the unprofessional fisherman. Okay, hold on. Let's see what we got going on here. I can't take too many practice casts or, you know, too many setup casts because of the fact that there's, I don't think it's gonna hold, but I gotta get the thing out of the eyes of the, hey, the problem when you have a small eye in the front is if you get that knot in there, you never get it back out again if you're using very light fly. So you just gotta make sure that you don't pull your knot past the first eye and you'll be okay. Now let's get that wet so it's castable. Let me get my line right here. Everybody's in the right place. Ready? Here we go. Might get one or two casts out of it. I'm not sure. See if I can catch a fish on it. Wow, look at the way it darts. See that? Look at that. That's fantastic. That should be a catch waiting to happen. I'm gonna let it drift. I'm not gonna pull it out yet. It's just looking really pretty under there. Fish don't feel pain, so they can do things that we can't, and survive stuff we would never be able to. I'm gonna let that drift further now. More line is out. Before I pull it in, I'm gonna let it go further back, a couple ticks here and there, and then I want it to go under those other trees, and I want it to go into the deeper spot there and try to pull a fish out. Now, I might have spooked this area because I ran the chainsaw earlier today, and I really, really messed it up here. I kind of, I don't think there's any fish in here. Let's try down here and again with this one. Okay. Move down there. I think the fish might have moved overnight. You know, the fish here, they don't stay in one spot very long. They continuously go around this place. And you've got to be a pretty vigilant hunter. Hey, butterfly. If you plan on eating here. This morning, the deer were so cool running through the camp. So I'm going to let it go the full length of that sandbar right there. I think you can see it. And every time, I give it a little bit of an extra kick so it just looks like a fish. And right now I'm on the deeper spot. I'm over the deep water. So if there's somebody there, he'll come up and pop on it usually. Now I want it to go a little bit further. So I'm gonna let it go underneath that stick right there. So I let more line out on the cast and I dart it in front of the stick, a little bit further back, a couple darts, let it fall back. Usually you get a lot of strikes on the fall back. Now a little bit more line is out. I'm gonna let it just tiny darts underneath the stick. Now push, give it some line. It goes back past the stick. Nobody's there. I would have figured somebody would have chomped on that one. But you know, if there's nobody there, nobody's there. It's simple. This spot might not be hot as it seems. And I have an underwater camera. I could do some footage. Maybe if I let that sink further. We'll see. Might not be deep enough there. Put it right there at the edge. Yeah, usually they dart up after after stuff. They're not finicky here because remember, this is a what do you call here? It's a real serious place to live. If you're a fish, you don't take time, you know, you waste time looking around for stuff. You are going to go eat it. And then you ask questions later, you know? You do the thing now, and then they ask questions later. We're gonna go through here. Gotta watch out, there's been deadfall all night long, dropping down on the ground. And it sounds like giants in here, kind of moving around. So you gotta be careful of these branches. Even this branch right here is, I got a hook in my leg. Even that branch right there can give you a real nasty problem if it falls on your head. This fly's kind of holding up, okay? I don't think it'll hold up past one fish, but I'm gonna try. I'm gonna take you to a secret spot in here. Every spot here is secret. This is all a secret. But here, we'll take you over here. Watch this. Okay. Now, this is where we were yesterday, up the tree. Oh, God, I don't have my hat on. I forget, and the stuff wants to jump in your hair here. I'm going to go downstream a little bit, okay? Come on. Oh, Lord, I thought that was a snake. Whew. Boy, I'm in rattler country, folks, so it's not like, oh, it's a garter snake. No, it's an anaconda or a rattler. Oh, God, that scared me. Okay, there's a couple deep holes here I want to try. That's like right in here. Let's see what happens. I'm going to show my hair's not in the camera. I need a haircut, you know? Okay, here we go. I'm a heavy breather, folks, because it's like, seriously, that stuff they spray is so toxic. Look. Anyway, that's not what we're here for. But I'm here to fish. I want to put this in there, right there. Oh God! Oh no! Don't get stuck on there. Right inside there. Oh, perfect. I can't. Like, I gotta shoot it in. There it goes. Tough spot under there, you know, like under the trees. Let's go over here. Let's try it in that little back corner. See, some of these fish get trapped under here. It's hard with these trees everywhere, you know, to cast. But in there might be somebody living. Here, right over here. Right in there. Paradise here for real. This is real Florida, folks. This is what the pirates came up to hide their treasure. Came up streams like this. See that edge right there? It's really dark in there. That's could be a lot of fish in there waiting for food to come by. So put the fly at the edge, let it drift down, work different spots of it. They love stuff comes off the shoreline. Oh, easy, Frank. No, buddy. No. Come this way. Get a different angle on that. I'm sure there's no gator in there. Please, my lure is, this is the only one I have. I made it. It's all I got left. I can go make another, but I don't feel like it right now. Actually, that took me about 2 minutes to make, and I'm going to show you how to make a quick fly if you ever need to. So I'll do that at the end of this episode when I get back to the studio. I'll show you how I made that fly. Folks, this is it right here. This is fishing. Look where I am. Look at this. I mean, minus that. But, you know, look at this. place is just, I'm gonna put that in slow motion, that little pan, so you can actually see it. Tell you the mosquitoes here could carry you off into the night. I'm having a hard time locating a fish on here. The river quiet. No, nobody. So we keep working our way down the stream. Fly fishing's fun. It's a very relaxing, very primitive aspect of fishing where you can really really feel what fishing's about rather than having to deal with technology. This is more of a finesse type experience where you're really connected to the fishing that you're doing. And I probably bought pliers, I'm stuck in my shirt now. Let's go this way. Hook I'm using is very small on this little guy here. It's very tiny. And I think it's about a size 12, maybe. 12, yeah, 12 petite. It's in the petites. But it's a fairly, I have some branches coming with me. Yeah. All right, we got the whole 6,000 acres to myself today. And MAGOO, we both do have this place all to ourselves. Sorry for shaky, I don't have my camera handle thing with me. This camera I just repaired on the go, on the fly out in the wild here. I had to switch buttons, pull some things out, and do some technological advancements and such and all this other good stuff. So now that we have a little bit more film for you today to shoot. And I didn't bring an extra battery, I'm kind of walking far from the camp, so I'm gonna go ahead and try to catch us a fish right here in this spot under the tree. Little wadis right here will often hold fish. But I don't see any activity in there or anything. Right here though, right here, I see a gar laying up right there, and some other fish will be in this area. If the gar is there, there's gonna be some other fish. So let's start ourselves in here and let's try to get that gar's attention. As we fall into the water, watch this, I'll get his attention. Oh, whoa! Did you see that? Somebody went after it. Okay, hold on. Let's see if we can't make it happen again. Oh, I got him. Oh, I missed him. He's little. Oh, there he goes. He's getting it, but he's not getting the hook. Or I'm not setting it on him. Oh, got him that time. Whoa, big fish. Give him a little line. Nice, dude, nice. Watch out, there's no gators under this edge right here. Move over here. Get over around here by the sand. I don't want to get eaten by a gator. Oh, actually here. Over here is probably better. Right here. There's a little bit of a lip. Whew, nice fish. Gotcha, buddy. Hi. Well, hello there. I shouldn't expect that to happen. Big nasty man up here. Don't worry, he's not gonna eat you today. He ain't gonna eat you. Let me get that little tiny hook out, because these little hooks are really, really good for getting into the spots there. Just give it a little bit of love. And there, it comes out. Okay. There's a nice little Florida spotted bass against the chemtrails. Look, he's got no dorsal fin. I might have caught him before. I have caught ones here with no dorsal. Spiny ray is all gone. So he's a very lucky little bugger. See ya, buddy. Have a good day. Thanks for the playing. Let's try it again. See if I can get some line back on that reel. And of course I'm all tangled. Oh, see, this is what I meant about the knot. The loop on the end gets caught in the guides, and you have to give it a little bit of help coming through on this rod. I mean, of course, this is a $10 rod from China, and it's, I'll be honest with you, $10 rod is not the worst in the world. I fish with economy tackle on this show because I have no choice, but also because I like to, because it's fun to fish with things that are really not made for what you're doing. And if you make them work, it's pretty cool, you know? I think I spooked the whole area there. Yeah, they moved down, the fish. Let's move down a little bit with them. Oh, there they are. There's a deeper pool right there. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, man. Oh, man, oh, man. That was a really nice fish. I don't think he'll come back. I don't know. Maybe he will. That was a nice bass, dude. He had a belly to him. I'll put that in slow motion for you. So the rope fly works really well, as we see. The rope fly really gets them chewing. So I'm gonna be making more of these rope flies. I'm pretty excited about that, how that works. Now, don't worry if you have grass on your fly, because you can actually make a fly out of palm fronds and grass and stuff. So I'm gonna show you how to do that one day, how to make grass flies. They're actually a lifesaver, and what the Indians used to use here, the Seminoles used to use for catching fish, they used to make lures out of them, out of grass. And it's an old trick. In Mexico, too, they do that. Let's get around the back side of this here, over here. This is another spot where I camp, right here. And there's gators here by the score, so I do be careful here. There's lots of gators in here. This is a good fishing spot, though. I hope I have enough film here and enough battery. I'm not gonna screw this up and get a really nice fish and batteries run out. That's a tree I climbed before, and there was a gator under it, and I showed you the gator from on top. It was kind of fun. Oh, that's not gonna work like that. You gotta skim underneath like this and try not to get the moss. I don't know, I'll do the best I can here. It's probably not gonna work out. No, it's too much, dude. It's too much. I'm gonna lose my fly in the moss. Let's move down here where it's open. Look, I caught a bunch of... Oh, this stuff is nasty, huh? Yeah, it's not recommended to go fly fishing around the Spanish moss, okay? We've learned that lesson. I've done some underwater footage here, too. Really kind of fun. Lots of fish in here. Lots of fish. If you'll see right here, there's gator slides all over there. Gators walk over that. Their tails go over the thing, and it makes a little slide mark. And I'm gonna let this fly fall back into that current right there, because I'm having a hard time casting it. So I'm just gonna let nature take its course and pull it back to where I want it. Now, normally there's a tree right there. You remember in some of my openers, there's a gator scene where I'm in the water with the gator and he bites into my camera and stuff. Well, that right there is where I did that, and it's all changed now. Everything here changes quite a bit, right, very rapidly. So your fishing spots will change overnight. Oh, we got one. Oh, he came up on it. He's coming after it. He's trying. Oh, boy. Oh, he's after it. Huge bass. Huge, huge. Did you size that fish? I'm tangled. Man, they chased it so hard before. What happened? I lost all sight of him. Whew, man, it's a big fish. The trick is you gotta get him back again after you chased it four times. The one freaking branch on the ground wants to make my life miserable. That's a good spot right by the beach, right there. Whew. All right, come on, baby. Get me a fish here. You, that's it. You coming out. Done with that weed. Holy cow, man. This is a tough one. They keep getting on that hook, but they're not staying on. They're not staying button. And I don't know what it is I'm doing wrong. That's what I didn't do right. I got him this time. He ain't a bruiser, but he's a nice fish. Okay? It's not a bruiser, but it's somebody out of that mess. I think it's a little shell cracker. No gators, right? Yeah, we're okay, we're safe. Let him fight. Come on, buddy. Where's the little bass? What is it, a shell cracker? Oh, he came right off the hook. Now, I'm gonna show you something about these shell crackers. Look at the size, that's no little fish. Look, when I tell you about fish surviving, that fish nearly had a spinal cord cut, okay? That's probably a bird, right? I would say maybe a bird or a gator got him. But he made it, he survived, and look at the size of him. That's a hefty bruiser of a fish with a massive injury who gets to go back again today. Bye. Who gets to go back again today because with that kind of a life, you lived a hard life, buddy, and you survived. But like I said, a human being with a chunk of their back taken out probably wouldn't have made it to tomorrow. I have a hangnail and I cry, you know what I mean? I have a splinter, I want to go to see a doctor, you know? So. When it comes to the point of humans and pain, pain is what keeps us alive because we know to take our hand off the stove when it starts burning. You know, and if the fish, like a frog, could sit in boiling water and never know it's boiling, you'll eventually know as a human being that water's boiling and you get out. Frog not know, just like fish. Fish not know is boil. What kind of words am I speaking? Fish not know is boiling. I'm a scientist. I have a vocabulary of three. Three what? I don't know. I don't know. But get him past the debris, all that underwater structure. Get him over here to fight. Yeah, man. Whew, look at bend that rod. Okay. Beautiful bass. Beautiful fish. All right. These are all edible and very delicious. And so, of course, a little fry right there. What you're gonna wanna do is keep some of these for dinner because none of these fish survive very long here due to the fact that there are so many predators, including people, that are gonna eat them. But we see that the rope fly is absolutely the badass fly of the day. And when I tell you that the tiniest little hook here makes the difference in fishing, you catch, the hook size has to match the fish's lip. Look at the size, there's not much left of that. But there you go, another little Florida spotted. He's got his spiny dorsal. Hello, buddy. You get to go back today. Another day in paradise. Go ahead. Choo! All right. Today you're not food, but remember this lesson. So when you're a human, you're more careful. When you evolve, tell your friends. Over here, see this little area here? This is where the gators will go and lay up in this shallow water here, but let's try over here. This is, like I said, this is another spot we camp. I like camping here. It's really peaceful, pretty spot. I don't know what kind of casting I can do here, but let's try and see if I get over here on the side of the bank. Gators could be in here. They don't have to be in the water. They're not necessarily always in the water. Gators like land. This is done by hogs. All this rooting here, they root up the one last go here. We're packing up the tent and camp and stuff, so I'm gonna, there's a whole bunch of fish moving in right there. Bluegill, I guess, or something. See if we can't catch one. Yeah, it's time to go home now. It's getting really warm out and they're starting to blast us up in the sky. So it takes away all those blue skies, disappear, and you just get these nasty overcast days here. So we're going home. Gator under there, I gotta watch out for. But the whole reel just came off the rod. Isn't that nice? I'm betting about zero today in terms of what's going on. And things just kind of falling apart on a grand scale. But you know, it's the first time back out into the woods. It takes a little bit of getting used to and back to order and whatnot. This has been overwhelming. It's been a rough re-entry back into the wild here. Well, folks, nice little fish for the last fish of the day. Put a little bend in that rod. His little jumper. Let's get him a little bit of a swing up on the bank. There you go. All right. Mr. Bass, thank you for joining me for the last bit of the show and showing everybody that my fly works pretty well. Sorry about that. Sometimes these little hooks could really become your best friend when you're trying to actually catch something, but also your worst enemy because you can't get him out. There we go, he's out. Nice little bass. Easy, buddy, easy, we're putting you back, don't worry. Lots of life left in him, lots of spunk. I wanna thank you, buddy. A little kiss for the show, and back to nature you go, get bigger. Folks, another episode. Thank you for joining me on this beautiful episode of G-Fish Outdoors. Outside in the wild. I gotta wipe the bass off my lips. And another episode and another day and on earth. And so I wish you a happy day. Buongiorno, folks. Buongiorno. Do your best out there not to get eaten by this machine, folks. Have a good day.